the Arabic something, then translate it to you and repeat after me.
Okay? You're basically going to testify.
Testify. Are you going to, what are you going to say? What is in your heart? You're going to profess it. Okay? So say, Ash. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasul Allah. You were a Christian before?
Yes.
Okay. Go to my to the people and tell them worship God and we are the message of God. He gave them something that differentiate them from the rest of the people. So when the people saw the things that they came with, they knew they are true prophets. For example, that Prophet Muhammad prophesied about the things that is taking place right now. He mentioned that 1400 years ago. Okay? For example, which one he said? He said about will come a time when you see the barefoot Arab man. Carefully, yeah? Competing in building tall buildings. When the Prophet Muhammad mentioned that, the Arabs were not known to build the tall buildings. Those who were known, the Persians, the Romans, the Egyptians, the Greeks. Let me ask you, where is the tallest building in the world?
Dubai.
So the question you ask yourself, how this man knew that? You know what I mean? Like, not randomly, specifically, precisely in details. Another prophecy, Prophet Muhammad said to the Muslim, there will come a time, the Muslim, they will overpower Constantinople. You know Constantinople? Istanbul now. Yeah? That took place 800 years after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. You know? So again, how he knew that? Are you familiar with the Bible?
Yeah,
okay. I'm going to show you something as well, because I want you to see that if you're going to become a Muslim, inshallah, you're not going to become Muslim because you just, as a Muslim, you just believe. No. Because as a Muslim, we have a tangible proof to establish Muhammad the true prophet. You know what I mean? Like in the Bible, Prophet Muhammad came to the Jews and the Christians. And he told them, my name and my description is in the Bible. Some of them said, no, they rejected it. I'm going to show you. Watch this. I'm sorry for taking your time. Yeah? Thank you. This prophecy, Isaiah 42. Servant comes to glorify the Lord. So this prophecy, Isaiah is a prophet, came before Prophet Muhammad, after Jacob and Moses. So he's prophesizing about someone coming in the future. So he said, behold, my servant whom I uphold, my elect one, in whom my soul delights, I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the Gentiles. You know the Gentiles? The Gentiles prophet is coming for the Gentiles. Okay, so it goes on to mention here, I'm going to show you the main point here. He said, let the village that Kida inhabits, let the inhabitants of Sila sing it. So there's two names mentioned here, a place and a person. Kida, who's Kida? So you go to the Bible, 25:13, and it tells you who's Kida. And this word is the name of the sons of Ishmael, by their names, according to their generation. The firstborn of Ishmael, Nabiyoth. Then who? Keda. So these prophets from here is not coming from the lineage of the Israelites. Jesus came from the Israelites. The only prophet after Isaiah came from Keda is the prophet Muhammad. From the Muslims and the non-Muslims. All of them agree with that. And here is more. Let the inhabitants of Sila sing it. Let them shout from the top of the mountains. If you Google Sela, watch. I'll show you Mount Sela, and you're gonna be surprised. Sela, look. Where is it? So this prophecy, so we look. Remember when Prophet Muhammad came and said, remember Prophet Muhammad in his time, he didn't have access to these Bibles. Prophet Muhammad's time, the Bible was not translated to Arabic, you know? So how Prophet Muhammad knew that? Because Allah told him, you know? Like, you know, every person is born to recognize the Creator and to worship Him. Prophet Muhammad mentioned that 1400 years ago. He said every newborn is born with a natural inclination. What is natural inclination? It's to recognize the creator. They should worship him. And now there was a study done in Oxford University and in Russia University. What is the origin of people? Is it to believe in God or not to believe in God? So what they did, they chose different children from different parts of the world and they asked them questions. They came to know after a few years, the research was done in 3 years and they spent 1.1 million about it, yeah, on this subject, on this project. They came to know children are naturally born to believe in the Creator. But Prophet Muhammad mentioned that 1400 years ago. Again, how he knew that? Because from God. See what I'm saying? So you, remember, you just agree that there's a purpose for us to be here. And our purpose is what? To show to worship the Creator. Let me give you an example. I always mention this example. If I give you £2 million, what would you say to me? Huh? Thank you. Would you remember me all the time?
No.
You would remember me. Tell you £2 million. You would remember it. You're going to speak £2 million. Okay, I will give you £2 million on a condition, give me your two eyes. Would you do that? Because your two eyes is more valuable than £2 million. What about the one who gave you two eyes for free? Why don't you thank him? So I'm saying, would you remember him, thank him? Like now, if someone comes with a gun, try to kill one of us, either we defend ourselves or we run away. Because why? The love that we have is so dear to us. What about the one who gave it to us for free? You see what I'm saying? Like, you know, the other thing I was going to mention, a person might say, I do worship the Creator, but how do you know the way you worship the Creator is the correct way? Because again, remember, based upon God's wisdom and His mercy, He did not leave it up to our intellect to come to a conclusion how to worship Him. Why? Because we have different feelings, we have different intellects. That's why He sent the prophets and messengers with the guidance and with the miracles to show the people the way how to worship the Creator. Like now, if you want to buy a gift for your friend, would you buy a gift that your love or your friend love? Likewise, you should worship the Creator the way He loves, not the way we love. Because the way we love, it could be subjective, you don't know. So what do you think what I said so far to you?
It makes sense.
Is it clear to you?
Yeah.
That you believe in one God, you should worship Him? But what we have to understand is, well, especially us, like in, it's a worldwide thing, yeah, but especially us in the West. To be honest, we are very, very busy with the world. We are so busy, but we forget about death. That one day we have to live this life. That's why Allah sent the Quran. Allah will never punish anyone until the proof has been established upon them. What does it mean? If someone explains Islam to you and you turn away from it, then no one should blame except yourself or myself. Because through God's mercy, like you never knew you're gonna meet me today. Even though you said you've been watching videos. You see on YouTube. You see, but never, but it's from God's decree. Because Allah said, Allah did not create the creation to punish them. Rather, He created them because He wants them to be His neighbors in the paradise. You see what I'm saying? So, if it's clear to you, what is stopping you to become Muslim?
Sorry?
If it's clear to you and it makes sense to you, what is stopping you to become Muslim? You see, so you should become Muslim.
Yeah, I just need to learn how to pray and everything.
Okay, I'm going to say the Arabic something, then translate it to you and repeat it after me. Okay?
You're basically going to testify.
Testify. What are you going to say? What is in your heart? You're going to profess it. Okay? So say,
Ash-hadu
an la ilaha illa Allah. Wa
ash-hadu
anna Muhammadan Rasul Allah. You were a Christian before?
Yes.
Okay. Wa ash-hadu anna Isa Rasul wa abdu Allah. I'm going to repeat it in English. Say, I bear witness. There is no one worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad is the last messenger and the servant of Allah. And Jesus, the servant and the messenger of Allah. Alhamdulillah, you're Muslim. You know what you just did? You went back to the origin you were born. you were born to believe in the Creator. But you know, because you were born a Christian family, so they show you a different way which you're born with, and that is to worship God. You know, you're about to cry. And see, say, look, you know why? Because now, remember, anyone, if someone tell me I'm going to meet the queen or the king of one of the country, I'll be very happy. But what about you? Now, do you know what happened to you? You entered, and now you have a connection with your Creator, the one who created you, the one who provides for you, the one who created your parents. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran. Oh mankind, oh people, remember Allah who created you and created your forefathers and the one who provides for you from the heavens and the earth. So wallahi, that is a big blessing. How old are you? 17. You know, that's a big blessing. Like me, my wife, she became Muslim when she was 14. She knows Islam is the truth.